Hey everyone, this is another hair video. This is going to be another experiment in my little Rapunzel Labs mini-series. So if you remember in my last video, I had showed you how much my hair weighs. In this video, I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to show you how much weight one strand of my hair can actually withstand before breaking. So what I have here set up, let me take off these balance weights right here. I have what's called a Newton scale. And so what it is it's a scale made from a spring that measures how much tension is on it when you pull this down. So this particular one goes from 0 grams to 100 grams, which is about the same as from 0 newtons up to 1 newton. So here's a close-up of the Newton scale. And so on one side you have grams, and on the other side you have newtons. So newtons, I don't know how many of you took physics, but newtons is a measurement of force, and force is mass times acceleration. So if you have something with a mass, then that is what it is in grams. And then acceleration is actually the gravitational force, which is 9.8 meters per second squared, approximately. So for instance, see, when I pull down on here, then the scale is calibrated up there and it's going to pull down. So if you have something of 50 grams, then the scale is calibrated to stop at about there. So if you have something that is, say, 50 grams, then that is 0.05 kilograms. When you multiply that by approximately 10 meters per second squared, then it's going to be 0.5 newtons.
So what I'm going to do actually is I'm going to hang this up, and I'm going to take one of my hairs, tie it so that one end is at the end of here and the other end is actually on this balance right here. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to have the hair in between the Newton scale and the balance, and then I'm going to put a bunch of coins on here. So I have these tokens. Each one is approximately 5 grams. And I don't particularly feel like pulling out a hair from my head, so I'm just going to take my brush here, and I'm going to use one of the hairs from here. I'm going to make sure that it is a strong piece of hair. It doesn't have any kinks in it or no splits, because I don't want any weak points. I want this to represent a healthy hair. So, finally, I've created my loop of hair, and I am hanging the scales from it. So, this is reading at approximately 24 grams. So now I'm going to start putting on these coins. Right now we're over 60 grams and it's still holding. Okay, so this is slightly inconclusive because I am now at 100 grams or 1 newton on the scale, which is the highest that it goes. And so we can pretty much safely say that my hair will hold up approximately 100 grams for a short amount of time. So it's been shown that one of my longer hairs can hold up to 100 grams of mass for at least a few seconds. But does length have anything to do with this? Well, I can repeat the experiment with one of my bang hairs here. So as opposed to one of my other hairs, which was about, that one was probably around 3 feet long. This one is maybe 1 foot long, if that. So let's try it again. So actually, my bang hair does hold up 100 grams as well for a few seconds.
So what does this mean exactly? If one of my hairs can hold up 100 grams, does this equate to all of the hair on my head being able to hold up an entire person? Absolutely. Keep in mind that this only takes into account the strength of the hair itself. It does not take into account the strength of the little junction proteins that keep your scalp attached to your skull. There have been instances in real life in the past of people having their hair caught in machines or in roller coasters, and instead of their hair coming out of the follicle or their hair shaft breaking, their scalp more readily separated from their skull and they lost an entire part of their scalp. So the hair itself is actually stronger than what joins your scalp to your skull. Now, can people actually be suspended by their hair? Yes. There are also situations of women being suspended by their hair. Their hair is actually lifted up by some sort of lever and they're able to hang by their hair. Unfortunately, I can't show you any pictures of it because it's not PG, but you know, Google images. So we know that Rapunzel can hold up one prince, but how many princes can she hold up? So let's simplify the calculations a little bit. Let's say that being conservative, a redhead is supposed to have the least number of hairs on their head compared to people of other hair types or hair colors. They're supposed to have approximately 90,000 hairs on their head. Let's say that a prince is about 90 kilograms, so a little under 200 pounds. You know, he's 6 foot tall, athletic. So how many princes can Rapunzel's hair theoretically hold up, not taking into account her scalp, if each of them is approximately 90 kilograms in mass, and she has a conservative estimate of 90,000 hairs on her head? This would calculate to one prince making each hair on her head withstand 1 gram. So if hair, my length, or basically any length, can hold up 100 grams, that means that Rapunzel should be able to hold up, theoretically, 100 princes. So I hope you enjoyed this experiment. If you did like it, press the like button. If you want to see more, and please tell me in the comments below. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye.